Hello and welcome to Code with JV. Today I'm going to show you how you can turn ChatGPT or another large language model into a personalized teacher that can create curriculum for you on the fly, teach it to you, and test your knowledge. This is blowing my mind. I've been a programmer for 20 years. I've been an educator for 10 years, and the stuff ChatGPT can do, it is amazing. I've put the prompt up on a GitHub repo. If you click on the init.md, this is good for a human format, and when you copy the markdown and paste it into ChatGPT, it helps it understand it. You'll see I'm referencing key terminology. I've got a bunch of instructions saying, ChatGPT, this is how I would like you to behave as a tutor. So it's got things like a course or a module, activities, projects, etc., which I'm using in particular ways to get ChatGPT to give the output I want. Let's paste in the tutor and see what happens. It's a really big prompt, and at the end of it, it just says, hi, I'm awake. How can I help you today? I've designed it to be optimized for creating course plans and module plans. So a course is a long series of study, and a module is a short one. Please create a standalone module to teach me the fundamentals of programming using JavaScript. Fires up a lesson plan, introduction to programming, JavaScript fundamentals, built-in objects and functions, DOM, practice exercises. External resources, videos. So these videos, I find that they're kind of, they're hit and miss, because the biggest flaw in ChatGPT is hallucination. It will just make things up, which it thinks is true, but aren't really. You'll see that this one, it's not the right video, so I'd just quickly close it. This one looks a bit better. If you ever get a situation where it's giving you links which aren't true, those links don't work. Give me three more videos, please. You can sort of just play roulette and start hitting it again. I find that usually that will get me something that is useful, particularly in a large domain such as JavaScript or programming, etc. If you're in a very niche domain, then not so much. Please create a lesson plan to learn the basics of archery, because it's ChatGPT. Let's learn archery, or let's learn gardening. This tutor can actually try to teach you anything you want. But I found that the videos in the archery one, for example, don't exist much more often. Whereas the coding ones, the videos exist much more. So the quality of the video recommendations really depends on the domain that you're trying to learn. Let's go back to the coding one, because it remembers the things it's done before. So you can just refer to it and say, here we go. Okay, that starts to look like a pretty decent, that's a bit more detail than I'd want in the step 5 practice exercises, but it's good, I don't mind it. What I would start to do here is you can say, do you want this changed at all? This is decent introduction. I'd like it to help me set up my development environment. Please add a step at the beginning to set up my dev environment. I want to use VS Code on Windows 11 using Windows Subsystem Linux. Now, if you didn't know much about setting up development environments, you might not ask for this specifically. But this is what I would recommend if you're on Windows. And this is where I think that a teacher and an AI tutor can start to be supercharged together. With a few tips, I can help you get much better learning plans. I like that plan. Let's save it. Code block, please. Here, I've got it generating the whole lesson plan in a single code block. Much easier to copy and paste. Let's go have a look at VS Code. This has never existed before. Real-time curriculum generation for you on the fly based off what you type in. It's amazing. Like the potential of this, you're starting to learn coding at a good time. Because what you can do is you can start to say, okay, let's call this one learn coding in js.md. So you can call these whatever you want. They're just names for text files. But if you paste them in, right-click Open Preview or Control-Shift-V, it will take your Markdown and it'll put it in a nice format, because Markdown's designed to quickly format code and make these links clickable, etc. You can quickly see what it looks like. You can also go and copy and paste the Markdown into ChatGPT, and this tells it like how important different things are. It's a good format for both people and computers to read. You can start to see these. You can delete things you don't care about. You can add things to it if you want. Or you can paste the whole thing into ChatGPT and give it instructions like less detail, more detail, cut this bit, add this bit, put in a bit of archery, please. Whatever you want, it will do. While I'm here, maybe what I'll do is let's go and get that init. I'm just calling it init for initialize. There's nothing special about the name. It's just a way of organizing files. But now I'm starting to build up some collateral, which I can use to copy and paste into another session in ChatGPT and say, hey, I'm learning coding. You're an AI tutor. I'm on step 4. Let's go. Let's have a look when you try and actually learn things. Say we're in step 3, JavaScript fundamentals. Teach me step 3. because I've designed the tutor to have three modes: creating curriculum, teaching curriculum, and testing your knowledge of it. So we're starting to jump into a dynamic lesson about these things here. It's giving me a breakdown. Let's go with the first point. It's starting to dynamically make a tutorial. This is a comment in JavaScript. This is the variable. Here's a function. Okay, next. You can also jump in and say, hey, can you please find a video for me? Or can you give me a practice exercise? And it will start to, on the fly, create a dynamic practice exercise testing your ability to do these recent things. You can start to give it examples, like I'm answering exercise one, is it correct or not? Give me feedback. You can do things like show an example solution to the five exercises. It will start to break things down. You can tell it to go slower or faster or more detail. You can also, please test my knowledge of this material. It can start to do little quizzes for you. If I could give you one piece of advice as an educator, you don't learn things by putting them into your brain. You learn things by trying to pull them out. Whenever you're in a situation of trying to remember something you learned a couple of days ago, and you're like, oh, that thing, that act of reaching for that knowledge and trying to use it tells your brain, hey, that stuff's important. You should keep it around and not just let it just fade away. The stuff you don't try to use fades away, which is why so much of education is about use it or lose it. If you were to do one practical thing to increase your efficiency in learning, whenever you learn something, a couple of days later, revise it, practice it, ask ChatGPT, can you test my knowledge on that thing we did 2 days ago? Then you'll start to have much less waste in your learning, much less putting stuff in your head and just throwing it away. Whereas if you put stuff in your head and try to get it out a few times, it'll stick with you for much longer. Really simple tool, but it's also a little bit unnatural. Not many people start to say, I'm going to write assessments for myself or quizzes for myself. Because when you look at online courses and tutorials, there's tons of them. How many of them have got assessment materials? What I'm really excited about this approach to learning is we can bake in this kind of practice. You can start to use ChatGPT to not just make dynamic curriculum and not just to deliver curriculum, but you can use it to test it over time. And I think this is going to change a lot of things. When I'm doing quizzes with ChatGPT, I really like things like ask me one question at a time, mix theory and practice. What are two types of comments in JavaScript? I don't even know what they're called. It's like one-liners and bigger ones. There's proper names for them, and you could ask ChatGPT and it could tell you. And you know, how do you declare a variable? You go like var a equals b, etc. This is where I would also say, if you're coding in JavaScript, don't use var, use a let or a const. ChatGPT didn't pull that up. It's really useful, but it's not perfect. I'm really interested in, when do you need a human teacher? When do you need ChatGPT? We've been going for a while. Do you remember what the lesson plan is? Remind me of our lesson plan. You can start to tune into what the whole thing is. Here we've got the steps in it. If it forgets, because if you do lots of stuff, ChatGPT can forget. You can go over, get your markdown file, drop it in again, or you can start a new chat and reinstantiate your lesson. Let's paste in the tutor. And if you look at this, see how this got like AI tutor for learning, tutoring assistants. When you just start with pasting in the tutor, I find all your chats look the same, but you can also go to a new chat and say, please create a course in web development. I know a little bit of programming and want to learn enough to build a digital marketplace for local vegetable growers to list their produce. And then paste in the tutor. Because when you do things like this, ChatGPT is more likely to give it a good chat name. So if you're saying like, please continue step two of this course and paste it in, and then the tutor things, often we go here. Okay, lesson plan. Please create a course, not a lesson plan. Because when you start to go in the direction of instruction, then AI tutor, sometimes it is not as accurate with the AI tutor language. Whereas now that I've gone and said, actually, I want a course, it's starting to use this layout, which I've instructed it to use. Each one of these is a module, getting started in web development, responsive websites, server side, database, user authentic, like payment systems, deploying. You're starting to go all the way from coding a little bit to deploying a functional website. Now, I don't know about these weeks here. I think it's just guessing and making things up. I wouldn't trust them too much, but this is a fairly large undertaking, and the amount of time it takes probably depends on how much time you're allocating to it. I've heard a fascinating story that there are a whole bunch of lawyers who are receiving false case studies from their clients. Their clients are saying, hey, I've gone and researched online and found this case study which might be relevant to my case, but the case study is completely fabricated because they asked it from ChatGPT. Because the biggest thing to know about this tool is it can hallucinate. It will imagine things that it thinks is real and present them very confidently. Unless you can verify that they actually are true, you're kind of playing with fire. But what's really interesting about coding is that often you can quite quickly verify how correct is this code because you can run it. And if it runs and does what you want, it probably is correct. You can't absolutely trust it, and you want to be careful before using it in an important situation. But for learning, well, you can run it, and if it works, it's probably teaching you good stuff. You will learn a whole bunch by playing with it. Yep, that's a good course of study. I like it. Save course as code block. And then here it will start to give me the code block, because I can just go and take this course and then put it in my study plan. Let's jump over to VS Code. Here I can make another one, web development course. And like I said before, these are just text files, so you can organize them how you like. You can go and tweak them over time. You can also start to put in, I finished this, finished, I built, etc. You can turn these courses into living study notes. And that way you're giving ChatGPT more context about what you've been learning, because when you show up for your learning that week, ChatGPT can keep adjusting to follow with what you're learning at the moment. It can keep following with what revision you need, etc. I think the potentials of this approach are really exciting. Now, so just like before, these are modules. Oh, let's do the payment systems module. Create a module plan for step 6 about payments. Here it's starting to build up custom curriculum for how to integrate into a payment system, and it's talking about Stripe and test forms, etc. Again, this is where you can start to save as code block. No matter where you want your learning to go, ChatGPT will follow and it will create stuff for you. And you need to verify, like double check the links, double check the ideas, look at other videos. You can say, hey, give me a video about setting up payments, and you can validate that it's giving you good stuff. But the fact that it's just making this as you go, I think this is phenomenal. So that's what I've built. It's a big prompt. It's on GitHub. The link's in the description. And I am so excited by the potential of this technology to transform education. Because when you start to have curriculum generated on the fly and curriculum taught on the fly, which a student can say, go faster or slower, or give me practice exercises. When you start to have a student being able to say, please test my knowledge, and using that appropriately, that's high quality education. And it is free when you know how to use ChatGPT. This technology has the potential to change so much in the education space. This is the main thing I'm trying to explore at codewithjv.com. It's a education experiment in how we can really lean on AI tools to accelerate and customize teaching. But also, what are these tools not very good at, and what would a human teacher be better for? So I'm here as the human teacher, really leaning on these AI tools to experiment with how can the two of us together supercharge people's learning? Can we increase the quality of education while dramatically lowering the price? That, I think, is the promise of this technology. Let's have a play and find out. Sign up for a weekly newsletter at Code with JV if you're interested. Subscribe to the YouTube channel. I'm just spending all my time on this now. Really excited to see where it goes. If you've used this AI tutor, feel free to give me feedback, make pull requests. I'd love to hear how you're using it. I'd love to hear how it's not working for you, so we can learn about how we need to tune it and the instructions to give it for it to really perform well for us. It's an exciting time to be teaching and learning, particularly teaching and learning programming. Because if you think about the boost that people get from using AI tools, it's massive. Like, it's already having impact on so many people. But if you're a programmer, you can use AI tools to help you learn and write code so that that code can use the AI tools. The boost is even bigger. I think it's never been more important to learn a little bit of coding, and it is a pretty exciting time to be around. Take care all.